Okay, this class is being recorded. I will send you recorded notes, running notes, video and material after the class. Whoever given me your email address, all people must have received the video, running notes and material. If you didn't get it, please send me a reminder email. I will add you to my mailing list. Have you guys received the email yesterday from me? Say me yes or no in the chat message. If you didn't receive it, means, you know, please check your spam folder and you send me your email address. I will add you to my mailing list. It looks like that almost all people received the running notes and material. Okay, perfect. Yesterday we had the orientation session. Today we will start with the real class. Yesterday we didn't discuss anything about the subject. Okay, what is today's date? September 15. Okay, great. Okay, so let us discuss the subject today. At the end of the course, you will be able to apply for manual testing job titles like test engineer, QA engineer, software tester, functionality tester, black box functionality tester, QA tester, QA test engineer, QA analyst, test analyst. These are all the some of the job titles. Okay, thank you for you know, receiving the running notes and material. Okay. These are the manual testing job titles. If you are trying to apply for automation tester, job titles are like this. Automation tester, QA tester, or BUT. Software development. Okay, these are some of the job titles you will see frequently. Okay, so performance testing is out of scope of this class. However, we can give you intensive one-on-one training on performance testing if you are interested. If you want to do this course, you will be able to apply for performance tester, load runner tester, non-functionality tester, these kind of the job titles. Performance testing basics will be explained in the manual testing class. And we will, in market, we have many other job titles like mobile tester, web services tester, backend tester, SAP tester, PeopleSoft tester, Siebel, mainframe, TTL, data warehouse, big data. Oh, so many. So many job titles are there. So these are all the specializations in testing. Now, till now, most of you are aware that, you know, testing means how? Once I do the manual testing, I can work as a tester. No, that's not true. There are so many specializations are there in the testing. For anything, for any specialization, manual testing is the base. Just like our medical field, MBBS. MBBS is the basic degree for a doctor. Right? Once person is able to get the MBBS, then only they go for many specializations like ENT, ophthalmology, gynecology, dermatology. Like this, many specializations are there. So without MBBS, doctors cannot do the specialization. And similarly, without manual testing, it is impossible to do these specializations. If you are a specialist, you will get more pay. You know, if you go to ophthalmology, you know, more pay, right? Compared to the MBBS doctor. Similarly, if you go for a mobile tester, okay, more pay compared to the manual tester. ETL tester will get more pay. Like this, specializations, you will get more salary. So I strongly recommend to do more than one specialization for better marketability. If you want more quick interviews, do specialization. If you are a BA, you know your job titles are like business analyst, system business analyst, user acceptance business analyst, BA comes to you, quality business analyst, you know, or QA come to you. Like it's many job titles are there. Okay, all of your mics are muted again. In case if you would like to talk, please unmute yourself and you can ask the question. One question from Manu. Manu, could you post the question to everybody? In case, you know, I will not answer to private messages. If you feel that you need the answer in the class, please post to everybody in the class. Okay, let us discuss what is going to be testing. Testing is nothing but comparison of expected results and actual results. That's it. Very simple. Expected result and actual result comparison is nothing but testing. If expected result and actual result are same, equal, okay, then we say that test is passed. If they are not same, not equal, then we say that test is failed. If the test is failed means it is a defect. Okay, so just we are trying to compare expected results and actual results. Let me give an example on real software, live software, software in production. What is meant by production? Production means software is ready to use by the customers. Production means software is in use by the customers or ready to use in by the customer. Can you say that this is a live software, this calculator? Yes, this is live. This is real. This is real software. This is in production. Most of you guys have asked me the question. I am from non-IT background. I never worked in IT industry. I have no experience in testing any software application. Am I eligible to work as a QA? Yes. Definitely can be able to work in QA. I will give you so many examples on real software or live software or production software starting from calculator. A very simple application I have taken here. This is a real software. Okay, so let me to ask you one question. If I enter 1 plus 2, okay, 1 plus 2, if I click equal to what you are expecting? Could you tell me answer? This is a very simple one. Just please give your answer. I wanted to make sure that you are hearing me or understanding me properly. What is the expected result? Thank you, Varinder, for giving the answer. So here, answer is your expected result is 3. Okay, let us see whether you get the 3 or not. Okay. Now let me click on equal to. Yes, I got the 3. On screen, I saw 3. So that means my expectation and the actual are same. My expected result and the actual result are same. Then I say that this addition test is passed. Addition test in the software is passed here. Here it is observed that a couple of people joined it. No need to worry if you joined it. You know, you can play the recorded videos. And you can set up a one-on-one meeting with me tomorrow. I can be able to assist you with your questions anytime during weekends, or if you are aware of that one. So that's the reason I strongly recommend everyone to join at least 15 minutes before the scheduled time. If you do like this, you will not miss anything. You know, please note that, you know, please assume that class starts at 8:45, not 9. Not at 9 o'clock, 9 p.m. Eastern time. Class starts at 8:45 p.m. Eastern time. Make up your mind like that. Then only can be able to get into class on time. Okay, if you join late, you will lose some of the stuff. Okay, so expected result and actual result is same. So then we say that test is passed. Let me give you more example. What example do you want me to give? Okay, let me do open pro. I'm opening Walmart.com. Okay. Here Walmart.com is open. Oh, you see very bad thing. You know, I hope that all of the people who are in Carolina, all are safe. You know, Hurricane Florence is giving very bad impact there. Okay. Fine. No, please don't travel to out of city. So here, what I observed is that I have seen some bug here. You know, this bug was not there last week. Every day I will explain you a lot of bugs in my classes. This is the real software or live software. This software is in production. Walmart.com is in production. whenever I see the website, any kind of website, I can easily find at least one or two bugs per page. Why? Because my observation is like this. You will be able to develop that kind of skill going forward in less than 1 year time. Your way of thinking will change after doing few freelance testing projects. So for a non-tester, cannot say that it's a bug. I am seeing some bug here. What is the bug here? Previously, this man, one week back, this bug was not there. Recently, this bug was introduced this week. It is impossible to avoid the bugs in the software. It is not possible to develop defect-free software in this world. It's highly impossible to avoid the bugs in this kind of multi-billion-dollar turnover companies. Bugs are inevitable. We cannot avoid the bugs, particularly for this kind of the big company. Walmart is a great company. It's in a top in the Fortune 500 company. Okay, yesterday we discussed that all of Fortune 500 companies is the top in the list, right? So, one interview tip for you guys. For example, you have applied for a job in Walmart. Okay, then Walmart HR manager will ask you, why you applied for Walmart? What motivated you to apply for Walmart? This kind of process they will ask. If there is a question, you need to give some smart reply, right? So you should know something about the Walmart. Before going to interview, try to learn what is meant by Walmart. You have excellent wiki pages are there. You can find very good information about Walmart in the wiki. Do you know the headquarters of the Walmart, where it is? It's in Bentonville, Arkansas State. What is the turnover of the company? In a Fortune 500, top in the list. This is one of the biggest company. What is the turnover? More than 500 billion. See, revenue is $500 billion. How many stores are there worldwide? 11,000. It's not the number of employees. It's not the employees count. It is the number of stores throughout the world. Employees count is 2.3 million. You can say that this is one of the best company, with more than $500 billion turnover and more than 2 million employees worldwide. So I would like to work in a world-class company. That's why I applied. These kind of answers are expected from the HR people. So every day we'll give you a lot of tips about how to answer. Okay. So it is must to know about why that company and history. There are so many subsidiaries for the Walmart. So even though this is a great company, there are so many bugs are there in this software every day because of thousands of the changes happening in the code or content. Code or content, every day, thousands of changes happen. What is content? For example, now this is a summertime, right? So fall did not start. Okay, fall, when is the fall started? I think 21st, right? Okay, still summer is there. That's why people are doing barbecue outside. So you will not see this advertisement next week. Now today is 15th, right? Next week official summer start date. Okay, if you check this next week, this barbecue advertisement will be changed. To change this, is it required to change, modify the code? No, this is the content only. This photo comes under the content. To change the content, code is not required to change. So content changes, these kind of advertisements, you may see different kind of advertisement next week. We'll see what is meant by code and content changes going forward in our classes. Today we have home appliances. If I click on home appliances, I can see a lot of products in my search. So many products are here. So this, if I go for this tableware multifunctional coffee, black coffee, this content is coming from a called content management server. here you can find lot of content, you know, about this item, features, brand, color, all those things, they may change any time. Because of all those changes, per day, you know, per month, they make around 30,000 changes. That means per day 1,000 changes. Per day at least 1,000 content changes are done by the Walmart. In the 2-4 changes. Because they have thousands of the pages. So many thousands of the applications are there. You know, products are there in the Walmart, right? So they may change, they make some changes. Because of all those changes, something may impact. Existing functionality may be breaking. Existing code may not work properly because of some changes in the code or content. Okay, because of those changes, you see, I am seeing some problem. Previously, last week, what is it? It was showing my name, Madhu Sodhana Tomara, or otherwise MT. MT means Madhu. Okay, my full name is Madhu Sodhana, but short name is Madhu. To pronounce easily, I say that Madhu, but my first name Madhu Sodhana Tomara, that was displaying here. Now I am not seeing that. Now I am seeing your account. There is a bug there, actually. Let me to log into some website, Amazon.com. Okay. I am trying to open Amazon.com. I want to show how it looks. Signing. Okay, so have you observed that, you know, like this, hello Madhu Sodhana. Have you seen that name? This kind of name is expected to see. Hello Madhu Sodhana. Similar to Walmart, previously it was displaying like this. Hello Madhu. Madhu Sodhana or my MT. It was showing my first initials, you know. Madhu, hello MT, it was displaying like this. Now it is not displaying. It is supposed to display like this. My name. Immediately after login. So it's a bug. Okay, however, let me to sign out first. It's already signing out, sorry. Let me to sign in because I did not enter the name right. Sorry, it's not a bug, but I will show you some bugs here. I'm trying to log in with my registered user ID on the Walmart. And okay, great. Now it's showing. You see, empty it was showing. You see? Previously, it was showing Madhu Sodhana T. Madhu Sodhana T, Krishnaf, it was showing. This kind of thing I have expected. Last time, you know, I made a mistake. I thought that it is a bug. That is not true. It's working good. Okay, this is, like this, I should see. Let me go to home page and click on that. Yes, perfect. It is showing perfectly. Okay, so some other, maybe I will show you some bug, you know, in the bottom of the page, if you scroll down to the bottom of the page, you are seeing 2018 Walmart. Is this correct? What you going to see? It's copyright, right? Okay, now let me to show you what is there in the home page. Home page, I am seeing like this. Copyright 2008 Walmart. Okay, perfect. As a tester, you know, you need to make sure that, you know, each and every item, you know, legal, this is a legal stuff, right? So you need to make sure that everything is showing consistently everywhere. Okay, so I will show you bug in a few seconds. Now, let me to give you some expected results and actual results. click on sign out again, I should be able to sign in. Now let me enter my username. Okay. If I click on sign in, what is the expectation? What is the expectation? What is the expected result? See, this is the data. This is the test data. Whatever I have entered in, this is called the test data. Madhusudan_T@yahoo.com and password is the test data. Did I enter the password here? Oh, I think I entered, but I am not able to see the password. Why? Because for security reason, as per IT standard, it should be masked. My password is masked here. This is IT standard. No company will give you that, you know, hey, password must be masked. No. This is a standard. So, whatever I enter here through keyboard or mouse or finger. Why finger? Because nowadays all are coming touch screens, right? Through touch screen I can type. Through keyboard or mouse or finger, if I enter something, that is called as a test data. Here with this test data, okay, if I do some action, action done by user, I am doing some action here. This is the front end. Front end means whatever I am seeing on the screen. Whatever I am seeing on the screen is called a front end. This is also called as GUI. What is GUI? Graphical User Interface. Graphical User Interface. In shortcut, it is called as a GUI. We can pronounce it as a GUI. Graphical User Interface or front end. And I have entered some data. Okay. As a user, I am clicking something. I'm making some action. What is action? Click on sign in. Click on sign in is the action. Service. What reaction I'm expecting? Could you tell me what reaction we are expecting? Anyone? Home page should appear and I should see the my name. First name and last name of the customer should see. Okay. On the right side in the my account. When I hover over my mouse, if I hover over mouse on the, my account, I should see my name. Okay. Then you click on sign in. I did some action. Now reaction from the software is that data will be submitted to the database. That is back end. All the way to, you know, Bentham Village did go. For example, assume that server, database server is there somewhere in the Bentham Village. In headquarters, all the data is being maintained, for example. I'm here in Toronto. Okay, from Toronto, when I clicked on this, all the way data did go to Bentham Village, it validated in the back end, that means database. And it is showing my name. When I hover over this component. Okay, my first name is there. Okay, so my expected result and the actual result are same now. So I say that my test is passed. If I am not seeing my name here, I say that test is failed. This is a home page or landing page. Yeah, you are right. This is whatever the page. First, when you open Walmart.com, if you see the page, that is the home page or landing page. Get it on account. Let me to click on account. Previously, I was seeing your account, you know, instead of account, I was seeing your account here in this one. If you compare that in the Amazon, you know, your account, your orders, you know. It was like this previously. Now they changed. It seems that they changed it. Your account, your address. So previously it was like that. Okay, fine. So here I can see all of my details, including shipping addresses, payment methods, all the purchase history, everything I can see. When I click on shipping address, I should be able to see what are all my shipping addresses. For example, my shipping address is this is the street name, apartment number, city name is King of Prussia in Pennsylvania State, postal code 19406. I should be able to see my shipping address. Okay, so now you understand. Okay, now let me show you bug. You know, I'm supposed to show you a couple of bugs, right? Okay, now let me search for something like pen or pencil. Okay, I wanted to order some pencils online because back to school is started, right? You need pen, pencil. I think all of you have finished your back to school shopping. Okay, click on add to cart. And click on checkout. You know, it's a great application for learning purpose. Don't underestimate Walmart. You know, this is Fortune 500 company, Amazon, Walmart, eBay, Facebook. These are all the softwares we use for our learning purpose. Okay, so errors Tuesday, September. Okay, we can continue. I have set up here my shipping address. The picture is seeing that the picture is issue. Okay. Okay, yeah. You see here, this is, no, they did not fix it. Here, what you are seeing, this is a payment page, right? Payment page. What you are seeing, Walmart thing is there. So this is the difference. So you have to report these kind of minor stuff also. In case they are there in the home page. Okay. So home page, in case they are there, the remaining pages, you know, payment page, you have the in. So these kind of minor things also you should be able to spot. Are you a good fault finder? If yes, then we can say that you are a good tester, best tester. Any minute things also you have to report. Oh, here my cards are expired. Oh, how to make the payment? I have PayPal account, but how can I make PayPal payment through PayPal? It's not there. Okay, let me click on more and see what happens. If you click on more, it has displayed so many other options like PayPal, American Express, and everything. I have seen one bug. I have noticed one bug here. What is that? If I click on more once again, what happened? What should happen? If I click on more again, it should collapse, right? It's not happening. So functionality I will show you. For example, go to get software service left. Tree, that the tree must be expanded or collapsed. For example, go to somewhere like Selenium training. Okay, Selenium training I'm going. You see here, Selenium basics. If I click on plus, what happened? It should open like this. Then it should show like minus. If I click on this again, it should automatically collapse. Expand and collapse should happen when we click on this one. In Walmart, this functionality is broken now. Previously it is working good. Now if I click on it, it is not collapsing. So what is the expected result? If you click on this, it should collapse again. That is not happening. If you click on credit card, then they are showing like this, right? If you click on more, it's not happening. This is a bug. Okay, now let me to make the payment by PayPal. Click on PayPal checkout. Oh, this is the software by some other company. Here one question from Manu. Yes, Manu, I am waiting. Just please ask me the question.
I think that the setup in Walmart site has been set in that way because you click on credit card or gift card or on more option, it's going to just show the contents in that option but not collapse. That will be in that way. If you cross check, that will be.
So, what you said, it's a bug or no?
I don't think it's a bug, because I think the option is set in that way that if you click on either of the three, it's just going to show the contents under those three.
Okay, it's a good thing. You know, now let me give you something. No, definitely I can say that it was working good previously, because I am explaining this for many years.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of, in Walmart itself, I have noticed it. However, here we have a conflict with the opinion. Okay, so one interview question for you, because situation came, I wanted to explain you interview question. Have you ever had any conflicts with your team members? Okay, all interview questions are right here. Have you ever had conflicts with your team members? Yes, they are related to my work only, no personal conflicts. This is one of the good answers. Normally, whatever you say, that may not be accepted by the customer. Sorry, not accepted by the developer or your some team member. So how do you resolve the conflicts? Ask this, like, hey, business analyst, we have something, you know, what I feel that, you know, here I should see the plus sign, but it is not there. You know, I feel that it is a bug. What do you say? You can ask your business analyst. So your business analyst will give you the answer. So sometimes you may have conflicts with the developer, you know, your thinking may be different and developer thinking may be different. Could you tell me who is correct here? Developer is correct or tester is correct? Both are correct from their perspective, right? Both are correct. So, if you are a tester, what you have to do? You have to put your legs in customer's shoes. That means think like a customer. Think like a customer and argue in favor of customer. Hey, I am seeing that this is a 9. You can argue, but developer eye, you may see that, you know, developer may think that, you know, the developer may see that, you know, this is a number 6, but you may think that it is a number 9. Only one of them is correct in terms of customer. So if we have any conflicts, we have to go for mediation. Who is the mediator here? Business analyst. Go to business analyst. Okay, business analyst, I have a doubt. Could you tell me whether it is a bug or not? This plus or minus, you know, we have just, some kind of confusion. Or you can say that, okay, Madhu's opinion is like this, whereas some other person's opinion is like this. You know, just please tell me, who is correct? Or what is the best for the customer? Okay, so Manu is saying like this, Madhu is saying like this. Who is correct? So how to proceed? Do you want me to raise a bug or not for this problem? Okay. Whatever BSS is, that is final. Because both opinions are not matching here, right? Okay, let us go for BS. We'll have these kind of situations all the time. Is it a bug or not? Every day we need to discuss. Okay, great. Now let me enter the password. What is the password? What is the password? Yeah. Forgotten. Okay. Okay, I think now I have entered the right password, I guess. You see, this is PayPal, it's not Walmart. Walmart handed over to PayPal here.
this is how payment it works like this. Here, it displayed my first name, Will. My full first name is displayed. And my Bank of America account is linked to PayPal. This is checking account is linked to PayPal. What happens if I click on continue button? No. Well, Bank of America pays to PayPal. PayPal pays to Walmart. Because PayPal is the intermediate person, they take some commission from the seller, from the seller, yeah. So here, if you observe this, copyright for PayPal is like this, 1999 to 2008. This kind of copyright is correct? I don't know, maybe, you know, if you are working for PayPal, you have to go as per the given, as per the opinion given by your business analyst. Your business may, business analyst may contact the legal team. Okay, so always you contact your business analyst. Okay, I don't want to make any payment. Now, let me click on cancel. I should go back to, what is the expectation? I should go back to Walmart. What is the expected result? From third party software. This is the PayPal. PayPal is a third party software. Third party means this is not the Walmart. This is some other company. This is third party software. Should hand over back to Walmart. Okay, reference to cancel. And that. Okay. So this kind of a functionality, we have seen some functionality here on real or live software. And all again let us come back to this running notes. You need not to write anything, right? Okay, let us give some more examples on GoToMeeting software. GoToMeeting software, all of you are using now. Who is the manufacturer of GoToMeeting? If you are a tester, you need to know these kind of things also. Who developed GoToMeeting software? Citrix company. Once upon a time, that is 2 years back, Citrix company was the owner of GoToMeeting. Now it is sold to LogMeIn. LogMeIn is another company. Now LogMeIn is the current owner of the GoToMeeting. Once you come to software industry, you need to acquire this kind of observation also. Who manufactured this software? For example, if you say Word document. Word document, who is the manufacturer? Microsoft. You are aware of that. Who is the manufacturer of this calculator? Microsoft. Maybe it is developed by third party company, but it is sold by calculator, Microsoft only, as a part of operating system. Okay, so now let us discuss something on another software which is in production. The software is used by customer, or ready to use by customer, the software is in production. Now I wanted to give you some requirement of GoToMeeting software. Requirement or customer need or story, all are same. Here are the requirements. Just please study the requirements for few seconds. I will explain you after a few seconds. Please study it. Okay, who gave you this requirement? In our company, there is a person called business analyst. Business analyst in a company will give you this kind of the requirements. Based on the requirement, you need to test the software. Okay, let us see. Participants of GoToMeeting are able to use chat messages. Are you able to use it? Yes, you are able to use it. That means you are as a user, you are the user, you are the end user of the software, you are able to use it.
Excellent. Participants of GoTo meeting are able to hear audio using headset or telephone. So almost all of you guys are using the headset to hear me. And one person is using the telephone, and Madhu is also using the telephone. And you are able to hear me over the conference without any disturbance. Audio clarity is very good, right? Sometimes you may experience audio disturbance. Why? Because your internet is not working good. That's why sometimes you see that few people are leaving the meeting. They are leaving the meeting means their internet is not working good. That's why they are leaving the meeting. And they will come back after 1 or 2 minutes. Meanwhile, their router will restart and they will come back. If your internet is not working good, audio quality may not be good. Presenter on GoToMeeting is able to use the drawing pens. Am I able to use the drawing pens? Yes. But what about, are you able to see the drawing stand? No. Actually, presenter only can see it. You see, you can, I'm the presenter, right? I can only see this kind of drawing pens. I can pick any color. You know, if I pick a green color in the drawing pen, you will see green color. If I pick a pink color, I can see pink color here. If I click an erase button, there is something called erase. This is the erase button. If I click an erase, all the drawings will disappear. Okay, participants should not see the erase button also. Initially, all software should be tested with a tester. Okay, and the final testing was done with business analysts as a part of user acceptance testing. That's why I say that business analysts must know how to do the user acceptance testing, how to write the test cases for user acceptance testing, how to write a test plan, test cases, test execution, defect tracking, reporting, all BAs must know. So BA should know both QA and VA concepts. Whereas QA should know only QA concepts. No need to worry about how business analyst how business analyst get the requirements. Here I have given you an example of role-based testing also. What is role-based testing? Or say the role-based security testing. Role means here I am a presenter. My present role is presenter of the meeting. Presenter only can see the drawing pens and the erase button. Presenter only can record the meeting. Are you able to record the meeting? You are the participant. Participant of the meeting cannot record the meeting. Okay. Participants cannot see pens and the erase button. They cannot record the meeting. As a participant role, you cannot do it. That means based on the role, your software should behave differently. In a bank, go to a bank in a teller. In a teller, teller can see the application for a customer. Loan application. If you go to teller, they can see your loan application. But they cannot approve it. They have no approval permission. Who can approve the application? Bank manager only. Bank manager can fill the application and they can approve also. This is a role-based testing also you have to do. Log into Bank of America as a teller and test it. Log into Bank of America as a bank manager and test it. Log into Bank of America as a customer. Here will be seen account transactions, but cannot update. Mobile or SIM number. Who can update mobile or SIM number? Bank manager.
If you go to bank, you know, physically, bank manager, actually the PIN number is a great thing, right? You know, you should not, I don't know whether manager also can update the PIN number or not. Manager definitely can update the mobile number. Or customer service representative. In our CSR, what is CSR? If you call to bank, you know, customer service number, service representative can ask you few questions and they can be able to update the mobile number. So same Bank of America, different roles are there. If you are a tester, you have to do all those role-based testing purpose as security testing. There are many varieties of security testing are there. Just I have given some examples here. Okay, any questions so far? Okay, great. Now, so far so good. Please note, testing is nothing but applying some common sense. Yes, technical skills are also required. Nowadays, SQL and automation testing tools are compulsory to do the test job. It's very simple, it's easy. Testing is very easy. Comparatively, development. Comparatively, software developers, testing is one of the easiest jobs in the IT industry. However, it is not so easy. Testing is not so easy, but comparatively, software development it is easy. You need to acquire automation skills and SQL, so that's why it's not so easy. Let us make it easy. I made the software testing is very easy. If you follow the instructions, whatever I give, this is nothing. Let me to give you one some small quick test, you know, simple test I will give you. Here I have one statement. Mary has a little lamb. Okay. Could you tell me how many test cases you can write for this above statement? How many tests you can do for above statement? Just give me some answer. Right or wrong, no problem. Just give me some answer. How many tests you can do? Manjira saying 5. Any other answers? Something is better than nothing, you know. You need some wrong answer also, no problem. I don't mind. Here, we are here to learn the stuff, right? Okay, great. Thank you guys for the thinking. 5, 7, 10. Excellent. So here are some answers. Just study the answer for a few seconds. So here, let me give you, Mary has a little lamb, Mary has a little lamb. So we need to check whether Mary has one lamb or more than one. We have to make sure that Mary has only one lamb, not more than one. Right? That means here each and every letter and word is also important for us. Every letter, word, sentence is important in testing. You need to have that kind of attitude. You have to work like James Bond 007. I know that many of you like to see the James Bond movies. Right? Behave like James Bond. If you are able to find the faults, you are the best tester. You should be a fault finder. You are a vision blower. Okay, if you find the faults, you are the best tester. Are you a good fault finder? If yes, this is the right profession for you. You should have detailed orientation. You should be a detailed oriented person.
You should work like a policeman, watchdog, janitor, gateman, whatever it may be. You know, you should not let the bus to go out of your office. You should not go to production. Okay. And you know, now you are aware of go-to meeting live software. Now you have experience on how to test the live software like go-to meeting. If you assume that you are a best tester for go-to meeting, you have worked as a tester for go-to meeting for a few years. Now WebEx, another company similar to go-to meeting, there is some other company called WebEx. They are hiring. They have asked you one question. No requirement document, no requirement document, no test cases. Is it possible for you to test our software? What should be your answer? Yes, I can test it. How? Because both work in the similar style. Actually, I told you that, you know, you can be able to drive any model or make for a car, right? If you know driving, you are least bothered about to make or model. Similarly, if you know how online meetings happen, these are nothing. Initially, most of you guys have worried about how about online meetings, you know, online training. How it should like this? I have seen so many reviews, so online meetings are not good, not able to understand. These kind of worries were there for you before joining the course. I hope that now you are not having that kind of issue. After seeing some private plans, this works great. If you use this effectively, online courses are very good. The difference on how effectively the trainer is presenting the course. You have the advantage of recorded videos also. Right? So in your company, real time also, you will be using these softwares because you have multiple offices throughout the world. Assume that you are in New York City, okay? You are in New York City, you have another office in Singapore. Okay, you have one office in Singapore. How do you connect to Singapore office? Somebody, you wanted to explain something to somebody in our Singapore office. Yeah, you can use GoToMeeting or WebEx or Microsoft Link. Microsoft Link is commonly used in the company. Just like instantly, you can share the screen to anybody in our office. You can discuss or the link itself directly, just like GoToMeeting. You can chat, you can share the screen, you can talk over phone through Microsoft Link, anything you can do. So it's a good experience for you about how to attend online meetings. You need not to worry. This is a good foundation for you to work on freelance testing projects from your home. I told you that you can do freelance testing projects from home, right? With this online meetings experience, it's a good platform for you. Online training are good platform to do freelance testing projects or work from home. How to connect your office from home? You have a lot of questions. You know, similar to go to meeting, or there is something called virtual private networks, VPN. VPN is there. Through VPN, you can connect to your office. Once you join in our company, your manager will explain you how to connect to your office from home. They will explain it. Let us see what is meant by functionality testing. Functionality testing means to make sure that software is working or functioning as per customer need or wish or requirement or story. Story and requirement are same. In the awareness of you, we call it as a story. If software is working good as per the functionality, you know, we can say that functionality testing is completed. Functionality. Let me give you examples again. What is functionality testing? Go to the requirement. Go to the functional requirement. Okay. Are the participants are able to do the chat messages? Is it functioning? chat messages, are they functioning? Are they working? Did I test it? Did I test this chat message? Yes. Then I can say that functionality, chat functionality is working great. I did chat functionality testing. I have tested audio functionality, audio conference functionality I have tested. I have tested a role-based functionality. Role-based functionality also I have tested. I have tested the arise drive functionality. Now, if I say that I have tested all the requirements here, I can say that my functionality testing is completed. It's very simple. Is this requirement is satisfied in our testing? If yes, then we say that functionality testing is completed. So you will work as a functionality tester. What is non-functionality testing? Other than anything, you know, functionality is called as non-functionality. For example, performance testing. We will discuss about performance testing in our future classes. At this time, I want to skip it. We will discuss more later. What is defect? Software is not meeting the requirement, that is called as a defect. We will discuss more about defect life cycle in our future classes. We will discuss software development life cycle, test life cycle, defect life cycle in future classes. We will implement them in some tools like HPALM Quality Center, JIRA. These two tools we will learn about defect life cycle and test life cycle again. If QA opens the new defect, then BA double check and make sure that there is a valid defect. And then only we will inform the developer. For example, I have some issue in the Walmart. What is the issue? I am not sure it should expand or collapse. If I click on more, again, it should collapse. That's what my understanding. I am not sure. Is it a defect or no? I don't know. Okay, let me do a contact with our business analyst. Then business analyst also will test it. And if required, business analyst will contact the customer. Who is the customer here? Who is the customer of software? Not the public, you know, Walmart.com public is using. But here, the business people will be contacted. Who are the business people of Walmart? Maybe somebody like Vice President Marketing. Vice President Marketing or that person's team are called as a business people here. So, business analyst will contact the business team and they will get the answer. So, we should not open the defect unless it is approved by the business analyst. Or initially open the defect and ask the business analyst to double check it. Is it a defect or not? Initially open the defect and assign that to the developer, business analyst. Business analyst will double check it. If it is really a defect, then only it will be assigned to developer. Otherwise, developer's time will be wasted, right? So never ever assign to developer directly unless you are confident. Again, that depends on the process followed in our company. It varies from project to project, company to company. Few companies say that they directly assign to developer. As few companies say that they ask the BS to validate the defect before assigning to the developer. On first day in our company, once you join in our new company, on first day, your manager will explain you the process to be followed. If you find a defect, ask BA, show it. If BA accepts it, then open the defect. There is a good process. What is incident? What is issue? What is the problem? Can we reproduce the incident on demand? Okay, here let me tell you something. Here, few minutes back, couple of you guys disconnected from the GoToMeeting. Have you observed that? You have observed that few people left the GoToMeeting. Why is it happening? Is it a bug in the software? Is it a bug in GoToMeeting? Can I make the noise saying, hey, there is a bug in the software? Is it a bug in the software? No. But assume that you are the customer of GoToMeeting. Assume that you are the customer of the GoToMeeting. If you call 1-800 number of GoToMeeting, what is 1-800 number? It's a customer service number. If you call customer service representative, say that I am disconnected from the meeting. What these guys will do? Immediately they will record an incident or record an issue or problem. We don't know whether it is a bug or not. Those people are not aware whether it is a real bug in the software or not. Immediately some incidents will be recorded. Later they will convert it as a bug. If it is really a bug, later the incident will be converted as a bug. Immediately then CSR will ask the question, sorry sir, no, sorry for disconnection. Is it happening consistently? Can we reproduce the incident on demand all the time? Are you seeing the same problem? That is the next question. Okay, for example, you are calling your cell phone to another friend. You are calling your cell phone to your friend. Your call is dropped. Your call is dropped. Why? Is it a bug? Is it happening all the time? Can we reproduce this problem? Can we reproduce this call drop problem on demand? No. Maybe there is some weak signal, or you may be going, you did go to basement, or you may be in elevator, or you are going by car. When you are moving from one cell tower to another cell in a car, or there is a chance for the call drop. Okay, so we cannot reproduce this kind of problem on demand. We can say that these are all intermittent problems. You know, on and off, we may experience this one. Intermittently happening or consistently happening, we need to give this report to the CSR. So if you say that I am disconnected from the meeting, no, it's not a bug in the software. Maybe they ask you, they will try to troubleshoot. Okay, sorry. Let us troubleshoot the problem. Let us identify the root cause of an issue. Okay. CSR will try to do the troubleshooting. If required, they will apply the workaround quickly. Later, matter will be escalated. What could be the probable reason for our disconnection? Is it environment issue? A software issue, or hardware issue, or configuration issue, or something else. Okay, environment, for example, your internet is not working good, or your software is not working good, or GoToMeeting software is not working good, or there is a problem in our handset, or your computer, or configuration, some problem is there. For example, one example for configuration. For example, I can configure my internet, okay, internet different internet I can configure. There are so many internets are there in my area. I can be able to correct for nothing, right? Yeah, you know, your my volume, I can increase or decrease my volume here. I am able to configure the volume. Okay, so these are all concerns of the configuration. What could be the probable reason? Or I can configure my time, date and time I can configure. Or I can configure my time zone. So what is the reason? They will try to identify. Root cause of the problem, we need to identify. If you are an analyst, test analyst or business analyst, you need to analyze what is the probable reason for the issue. And accordingly do the troubleshooting and apply the workaround quickly. For example, you are not able to hear me. You are not able to hear me over headset. This is the problem. Participant of GoToMeeting is not able to hear over headset. That is the problem. Then CSR may tell, hey, sorry, sir, could you dial the conference number? Your presenter of the meeting has given you conference dial-in number. Dial to that number. Then you can be able to hear the voice. Is there a workaround? If something is there, we have to suggest quickly. That's the job of QA analyst, test analyst, or business analyst. QA finds an issue that should be confirmed with BA. Then we will open a defect and assign to developer. This is the process in one of the companies. The process may be a little bit different. This is one of the best process. Any questions so far? Okay, great. Now let us see why you have a black box testing. Just please go through this for a few seconds. I will explain you black box testing after a few seconds. Okay, let us discuss about black box testing. Have you ever heard of black box word outside software industry? Did you hear this black box word? Anyone? Anytime? Yes, when there is an aeroplane crash, normally we hear this, right? Malaysian Airlines was crashed, but we are not able to find the black box till date. I think you are familiar with this kind of thing, right? So what is black box? In an aeroplane, you have black box voice recorder in a hard box, you know, in a one of the box. It's a very hard one. You cannot destroy this by fire or water or impact so easily. In this box, you have a voice recorder. Whatever the discussion happened in a pilot's cabin, you recorded in this. If aeroplane is crashed, after opening this box, we will come to know the reason for the aeroplane crash. If some problem is there, that means aeroplane crash. Aeroplane crash is a problem. To identify the root cause of the problem, we have to open the box. Unless we open the box, we are not aware of the reason for the problem. Okay, that is black box in travel industry. What is black box in software? This is a computer. Inside this computer, you have the code. Okay. If you are a tester, no need to worry about the code. Code, language, or logic, no need to worry. You are concentrating only on input and output. How the software works, you are least bothered. If some problem is there, it is not required to open the code to identify the reason. To fix the problem, you are not required to open the code. Who will open the code? Developer. Developer in a company will open the code. So if your input something like, for example, your input to screen something x equal to 2, you are supplying some data, some 2. You are expecting some value as output like y equal to 4. How we got this number 4 on the screen as a part of y output? There may be some logic like y equal to x plus x. Is it the logic? I don't know. This logic is applied by developer or not. What language is used? Java, .NET, C sharp, Python? I don't know. I'm least bothered. If I'm not seeing number 4, I will report the bug. Or is it the logic is used, y equal to 2x or y equal to x square or y equal to x multiplied by x? What logic is correct? I don't know. bug is there, my job is there to report that as a bug. That's it. Black, I mean dark, I don't know what is the code, but I'm not seeing my expected result. If we are not able to see your expected result, report that as a bug. That is a job of black box tester. So here we functionality testing also, as a part of functionality testing, you will be doing this black box testing. You know, both black box testing and functionality testing, you are testing together. They are not, both are not different. At a time, you are doing two activities. How you can do two activities at a time? Just like watching a movie. When you say that you are watching a movie, if you hear the dialogues and if you are seeing the movie, both audio and video, then we can say that you are watching a movie. Okay. What is white box testing or unit testing? Yesterday, one of you guys have asked me this question. What is the when we unit testing? Who asked that? Manu? Okay. So, unit testing or white box testing are out of scope for a tester. Those are developed by developers or programmers or coders. The testers are not responsible for a white box testing or unit testing. They are not bothered. Why? Because it is not required to open the code. It is not required to open the code. A tester is not supposed to open the code. So that's why we are not bothered. How to do the unit testing? What is unit testing? As I said, this is out of scope for you, right? But however, if you wanted to know what is meant by white box testing and unit testing, you can check here in the wiki. Unit testing wiki. Let me give you that. Just please go through this answer, and if you have any questions, I can give you. I'm not explaining because it is out of scope for tester. No one will ask you in the interview what is unit testing because this is not our job. There is a job. James called you. James from the recruitment company called you. Okay, Manu. We have one position for white box testing. I think somebody saw, if not Manu, somebody else I asked yesterday. This is the question. James asked this one. We have one white box tester position. Are you interested? What should be your answer? No. I'm not meant for that. I am not aware how to do white box testing. So please know test word is there, but you are not responsible. So Test word is there, but it is not done by a tester. That should be done by developers. Similarly, gray box testing. It's a mix up. How you get a gray color? It's very easy. You know, once you turn into 40 years, you will get a gray color, right? Or you can mix black and white box, then you will get a gray color. It should be performed by a developer. It's out of scope for testing. No need to worry about how to do the gray box testing. Sometimes you will open the code. Sometimes without opening the code, we have to test it. So this is not the skill of tester. The job, the intended, whatever the job you are trying to apply, you know, that is not satisfying gray box requirement. So you are, this is out of scope for you. Similarly, mutation testing is out of scope for you. Developers introduce bugs intentionally by manipulating the code and testing the software. This is not for you. Okay, one reminder for you guys. I did not see many registration yesterday. So please register. Please register on the website. In case if you did not register, you know, on the website, please register there. And I will approve your login credentials. And if you did not receive yesterday's sending notes material, please send me email. It is obvious that a few new people joined today. Please send me your, if you joined class today, please type your email address in chat box or send email to this email address. Then I will send you running notes, material and recorded video. If you need it, it's optional. If you want running notes, video and material, send me your email address. Otherwise, no need to worry. So let us see what is going to be application on the test. For example, I wanted to test this calculator. This calculator is the application on the test. Or I wanted to test Walmart.com. Walmart.com, I want to test. So then this Walmart.com is called your application on the test. Some companies call it a system under test or software under test. Both are same. Art and SUT are same. Every day we will be learning many technical words. Okay. So what is meant by business analyst? Business analyst document is a customer requirement or story or need. How business analyst document is based on the recommendation by business team. What is the difference between BA and business team? In Walmart.com, go back to Walmart.com. Okay, I'm trying to open home page on Walmart.com. So we are in the home page now. So when this Walmart.com website was created, did you see? Did you see this Walmart.com website 20 years back? 20 years back, did you see this Walmart.com website? No. Why? Because in those days, internet was new. You know, when the internet was introduced? When the internet was introduced to this world? Around 27 years back. Prior to 27 years back, no internet was. No internet. Oh, that means all of you had cool life at the time. Now we have Walmart, Facebook, WhatsApp, all those things are there, and it is killing your personal time. Your day starts with WhatsApp messages. Your day ends with WhatsApp or Facebook. So 27 years back on, internet was introduced. So imagine those days how you are able to pass the time. Okay. So 20 years back, only this Walmart.com website was introduced. But what about the computers in Walmart physical stores? In Walmart physical stores, computers were there in 20 years back? Yes. 20 years back, in physical stores, Walmart physical stores, computers were used. Okay. So the background for Walmart.com development is that the board of directors decided that how about introducing this Walmart.com website for our business goal. What is the business goal? Business goal is that increase sales, increase customer satisfaction, give more convenience to customers. They should be aware of products available in Walmart. They should be able to do online shopping. This kind of customer convenience, customer satisfaction, thereby increase the sales or revenue of Walmart. There is a business goal. Okay, well, this business goal is good, but how to implement that? Who can do coordinating? Who can coordinate to implement this Walmart.com? The person is business analyst. Business analyst translate business ideas to software requirements and documenting.
So business analyst prepares GUI, graphical user interface, that is front end, on a paper. You know, for example, business analyst may design the Walmart.com website on a paper. Okay, business guys, are you expecting a logo here, my account here, our store located here, and some advertisement here, you know, some promotions here? You know, is this kind of GUI are you expecting? Like this, they show some kind of GUI to business team, and they conduct a series of interviews. It means they apply some elicitation techniques to get the business ideas, and they translate their business ideas to technical requirements, that means software requirements and documenting them. This is not so easy job. Project success and failure depends on the BA. If BA is not there, or BA communicate incorrectly, millions of the dollars goes waste. BA role is very critical. You should be able to talk with top people like vice president, all the people, and you should be able to communicate those things to very good experienced people like architects, senior developers, testers, leads, so many people. It's a kind of coordination job. Of course, project manager is there. Project manager role is different. BA role is different. BA is the critical person for project success. Everything depends on the requirement only. If you give the wrong requirement, it is very difficult to deliver good stuff. Assume that there is no BA in your company. What happens? No BA? Oh, too bad. Okay, let me show you one example. BA will create mock-up screens, sample screens, and by using some tools like Oscar, Front Page, and get the approval from the business team. BA is a liaison person between customer and software team. Software team means developers and testers. BA is a bridge or coordinator. BA applies elicitation techniques and find the exact requirement from the customer. BA also will do user acceptance testing before handing the software to the customer. BA will do this kind of business acceptance testing. There is no BA, what happens? I think most of you have seen this document already in many companies. I will just go through this for a moment. This study, I will send the document, no need to write it.
Hello, Madhu, I can't hear you at all.
Sorry guys, I was unmuted. Okay, thank you. Here, there is no coordinator, no BA. Then customer need to explain the requirement, right? Customer is a computer literate. They don't know how to explain the requirement. So they may explain like, actually customer needs this kind of simple swing. Instead of simple swing, they explain like this by mistake. Project leader may understand like this. Design engineer design like this. You know, there is no BA, so
everyone is following as per their understanding and whatever they think. Sales people, you know, they explain anything and no project documentation. Operation team install like this. Customer is billed left and right. No help desk support. This will happen if there is no business analyst in our company. Now you understand the role of BA. If no BA, what happens? Our poor BA or weak BA. Weak BA in a company means projects will happen. Project performance will be like this. We need to have very strong, experienced person as a BA for a successful delivery of the project. Project success depends on BA, not on the developers, not on the tester. BA must be very strong. Okay? Fine. Now let me go to next topic. So development means developers, testers, BAs, database admin, everybody. Not only the coders, you know, everybody in the team is part of the development team. Okay, let me give an example for functional requirement specification. One of the university wanted to develop some calculator. Have you ever seen calculator in university? Did you see any mass calculator software? Can you test it? No, right? You never seen it, you never tested it. Okay, assume that you are a tester for mass calculator application to be developed by a university. One of the company hired you. Okay, so the initial BA will collect the requirement. Now, who is the business people here? In this example, who is the business people? University professors. University professors are called the business people because they want this software. There is no business team actually. University professors are the business people. Can we contact each and every university professor? No. We have to identify one of the product owners. Product owner means there are hundreds of the professors are there. Business analyst need not to contact each and every professor. Business analyst will contact one person called a product owner for any clarification. Single point of contact for a clarification. As per their methodology, is called a product owner. So initially business analyst will draw this kind of the diagram. Okay guys, what is your requirement? Okay, so they explain the requirement. Then business analyst explain like this. For example, if I enter 70 marks, click on submit button. What you are expecting? Software calculate the grade and it should display something like grade A. Grade A should display on the screen. That is a requirement. So based on this requirement, they conduct a lot of interviews with multiple professors, and the business analyst arrived with some requirement. Requirement is like this: marks are less than 35. You should show fail grade. Okay, 35 to 49 grade C, 50 to 59 grade B, greater than 60 grade A. Marks range 0 to 100. No need to marks are allowed. Numbers only are allowed in the marks field. Okay, these are all the requirements. Now let me to ask you one question. If I enter 99, what grade it should show? You have never seen this software. You have never seen university software. Can you test this? If by entering 99, what grade you should get? Yeah. Thank you. How you are able to tell? Because BA already given you the requirement. BA given you a requirement, they explain you in a meeting room. On a whiteboard, they have explained, BA explained you this kind of diagram and they told you. You have never worked in software industry, but still you are able to test it now. Okay, good. That's how it works. Always you have somebody to help you. QA has an advantage that somebody will help you, either a BA or a developer will help you. BA has no chance. You know, BA need to drive other people. BA need to explain everything to all the developers and testers. BA will get this kind of explanation from the client. Who is the client here? University professor. University professor is a client. BA get this requirement from the client and they will explain to the software team. Okay, now just I wanted to make sure that all of you are able to hear me properly or not. Could you tell me what grade it should display if I enter 60 and click on submit button? Could you answer everybody? Please answer everyone. I don't want anybody to idle mode. Please answer this one. Everyone, please answer this. What grade we should see? Are you sure? Here, all people made the mistake because I have given you pressure. Timeline, shrink the timeline. If there is no sufficient time, all people make the mistake. Now, I am giving you enough time to do the testing or enough time to do the development. Now, study the requirement and tell me what grade it should show. Now I am getting different answers. None, B, very nice. So why is it happening? Because there is the ambiguity in the requirement. Something is missed. Here equal to is missed. If it is greater than or equal to, no confusion. Okay, if equal to 60 watt, it should display. There is no requirement here. If you are a tester, you need to ask the developer, BA, hey BA, it looks like that there is something is missing. Before software development itself, you have to ask. You have to review the document. Why you have to review the document? This is the document, right? This is not moving. This is not the art. This is not the art. Okay, this is just document. It is static one. It's not a dynamic one, it is static. So you have to do the static testing. This is also called as a review. Review means document testing. What is the purpose of review? Uncover the documentation defects. Is there any problem in the document? You need to check first. Before software is coded, you have to do the documentation testing. That is called as a review. Hey, the business analyst, there is a mistake. What if if I have 60? You have to ask. So that means your testing starts from the document itself. No need to wait till code is completed. So you can uncover the documentation defects also. Later you can go for dynamic testing. What is dynamic testing? Actual testing on the art. This is real testing on software is called as a dynamic testing. Okay, yes, any questions? Okay, let us, I have taken some 4 minutes extra. Tomorrow we'll discuss about black box testing techniques. This is a very interesting black box testing technique. We'll discuss those things tomorrow. Any questions, anybody from today's class? Okay. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me tomorrow anytime. You can contact me weekends anytime. It's not a problem. Tomorrow I will give you a lot of homework. I will make you busy entire week by giving a lot of homework today because it's the first day of the class. Yesterday orientation, today is the first day of the class. So I don't want to put you on pressure on the day one. Tomorrow onwards, you will be overloaded. Okay, guys, so whoever gave me the email IDs. All people will receive the running notes, material, and recorded video. Please check the staff board also. If my video is not there in within 1 hour in our mailbox, please send me the mandatory email. Okay, great. Yesterday, whoever gave me the email IDs, no need to give my name. New people only, just give me that. Okay. Thank you very much, guys. Can meet tomorrow. It's a good weekend. Good night. Thank you. Bye-bye.